And then we go through the timeline. You know, with the Emancipation Proclamation of 1836, we had millions of slaves that no longer were the responsibility of their white masters, and they were literally on the street. On the street, many not able to read or write. Many really not knowing what their future would be. And we really investigated the timeline of history. You know, when Reconstruction occurred, out of that came racism, the Ku Klux Klan, and of course the urge for blacks to get out of the South. And then one very interesting factor that led to a lot of blacks moving out of the South was a bull weevil, a Mexican bull weevil, because it crossed the Rio Grande and as it invaded the cotton fields, agriculture in the South went down. So folks had to go places. And since retail merchandising, mail order retail merchandising, was started right here in Chicago, which is robust and hungry for it, many blacks in the South knew of Chicago because you got that catalog and you were able to order things and you saw master getting these boxes shifted and Chicago was on it. And then more importantly, the Pullman Porters, first black man established right here in Chicago, to bring the message, and the messenger was the Chicago defender, Bill Jackson, who brought us to Chicago, symbolically. But we go through the timeline, and we take it right through World War I. You know, we have the 8th Regiment Monument at 35th, the 8th Regiment, the Jones Army, General Jones, down in 15th, a second in Cottage Grove. We talk about the Great Depression. And we focus on what was needed for folks who could not read and write, they were literally slaves. What was needed for them to pack up, make a determination to come to the promised land. That's a really important thing because these folks came with some desire to improve their lives for themselves and for their children. And of course, because of the land covenants, there was a restriction on where blacks could live in the city, and of course, Roswell came to promise. Sinclair, Drake, and Horace are claimed for the book, the great of the black metropolis. And it focuses on all the elements that created this incredible neighborhood. And these are all that have made contributions, and right in the center of that, we put our young people and we examine the qualities they had. Robert Abbott started the Chicago Management with his mission. It became the largest black newspaper in the country. And one of the emphasis in getting folks out of the South, Dr. Daniel Bell Williams performed the first open heart surgery right here in Chicago, Robin Hospital, the first integrated teaching hospital in the country. Ida B. Wells and her husband, Fernando Rivera, this is a love story beyond compare. These two folks, she came to Chicago, 1893, chased out of Tennessee because she wrote about the injustices her people experienced there. She came to the Columbian Exposition. She was quite upset with the fact that blacks were not represented properly. And then she teamed up with Frederick Douglass, and he had a pavilion there where he talked about race relations. She married her husband, an attorney, and they started the first black newspaper in the city. And this lady single-handedly brought the awareness of black men being lynched in the South. Now many people, when I say Ida B. Wells, they think of that housing project down on 39th and Cottage Grove, and they think about how it was a distressed community. Let me say the sidebar. I went to the CHA commissioners and I said, you know, we need to honor Ida B. Wells. And they said, oh, we don't want to mention that name. People have very good feelings about Ida B. Wells. I said, you know, not Ida B. Wells about you, CHA. They have those feelings about you. Ida B. Wells needs to be recognized for her efforts. Anthony Overton, a millionaire, one of several millionaires at his time. In Kansas, he produced bacon soda, in Chicago to produce college managers like Wood and Heath and C.J. Walker. Got together, they made millions. Let's see what I'm saying. Okay, Jesse Bingham started the first black bed, right? Incredible man. What elements and intentions by God in the 1800s and established a bed? What vision did he have? And is that vision transferable to our young people today? I think it is. Dr. Margaret Burroughs created the solidly sent back on American history. She, along with the Baptiste Foundation, a group of educators that kept the message. You know, it wasn't until the 60s that the city truly recognized a black man being the first citizen in Chicago. And it was her efforts that created the Usopolis, and she started with Wright and her house, which is a mansion at 36th and, or 38th in Michigan. It was actually the home of the Pullman Union, because, you know, Pullman porters could not stay over at hotels downtown. In fact, any white man that could get a room at a hotel downtown was George Washington Carver, the lady during that time. So anyway, she lived in the coach house of the mansion. She was a student at the Art Institute of Chicago, and then the Pullman porters dismantled. They